April 18, 2016. How to rip your legally bought CD collection with FLAC. So this I'm gonna rip today is Led Zeppelin 2, 1971. First, let's learn about FLAC, the audio codec. Okay, we're gonna use Benchy media player. Okay, we're going to use Benchy Media Player. Okay, I'm gonna use this software here to this program to convert my CD the CD. I wanna use this app to rip the CD to FLAC. First of all, I want to open another player here. So I can have our music play in the background. Let me see, rhythm box. Okay, I'm going to go to menu, sound and video, Banshee, now you go to go to edit with a preference. Go to source specific. On the source here, you click audio CDs. And then America have the free lossless audio codecs. You can have this on America input out to this when insert and eject when not important. Thank you. click on all it's in the bottom here where you see my mouse. Now we're gonna enter the information of the CD. Let's see if you can get the information, but if you're not, you gotta put it manually there. The size of the CD is 418.4 megabytes, and it's 41.4 minutes, the duration of the CD. Okay, you don't have to manually put the information because it automatically downloaded the CD information. The only thing you have to do now is click try something here first. I have different software on my computer that play music. I'm going to show you how to rip it. Use different software. I'm going to use this one here automatically gave the song information, so I don't have to manually enter the information. I'm gonna do the one that you can do it automatically, like this one here, and the one that you have to input the information. On the bottom here, I just show you the progress of the whipping progress. And this one here is not giving the information. I'm gonna have to enter the track manually. Kind of have the information here. I have to do manually. Okay, first let's check the other one. I'm going to open my music folder. As you can see, it created a folder, and all the songs converted to FLAC. This is in a program called Rhythmbox. This one is the easiest one because it already gave me the information. I didn't have to go to the web. I didn't have to manually input the information. So this is a written box. It already gave me the information that I needed. So I would recommend this one first, because you don't want to be manually importing songs, typing the information. In this case here, since you already created the CD, what I'm going to do here another folder here, so I can have, I'm going to call a folder rip, and I move this one to inside of it. So to rip CD with the rhythm box, you have to go to, you click here, go to preference, and then you gotta specify. You can specify where you want to rip the songs. In this case, here is on my music folder, and you have to specify the codecs. So always go with FLAC, because FLAC is the best one. You don't lose the quality of the song. And then you just have to do is extract. Click on extract, it automatically will extract the CD. If you want to eject the CD, you click here. So you just have to change to FLAC, put the CD on the CD-ROM drive, DVD-ROM drive, go to you click here, go to preference, then you can specify what folder you want to save it. I would leave on the music folder. Then you have to specify this the FLAC as the format. Click close, and then you click on extract. That's it. Now we're going to do the same with so I already manually put the information on this one here. You just have to do is click here, import CD. You can make a copy of the CD or you can import the CD. So we click import. Now we're going to start to import the CD. As you can see, you already created a folder, my music folder. On the bottom here you see the progress. Thank you. Okay, it's finished, and I check with V. Okay, now what you have to do is just, as you can see on my music folder, I already have named Led Zeppelin 2. Oh, you ripped the wrong format. I'm gonna have to rip again. On the wrong format, but anyway, you gotta go to the tools, with preference, and the source, the music here, the LCD has to be on 3rd, and that pretty close. Now that's nice, so I don't have to do anything now. Now I think it's because I changed the settings, but I don't know why it kept the MP3 file format. But now, as you can see, I had it set it to automatically every time I insert a CD there to automatically import the CD for me. After finish to eject the CD, as you can see, it's a little fleck. As you can see, it imported all the songs on FLAC. The other software, I'm gonna close this one. Software you can do that is called Sound Juicer. First, let me put the CD first. Click open with Sound Juicer. Okay, this one here, it got me. This one already got me all the information. I just have to do is type here rock. That's it. Now you can play and you can extract. So what I'm gonna do, I'm gonna go back to the music here. I'm gonna delete the Led Zeppelin here. And I'm gonna rip it. I'm gonna click here. First of all, let me see the settings here. You go to settings, preference. It gives the name of your CD burner. You have the option to open music folder when finished. And you can select the folder that you want to save it. On this case, I'll leave it on music. And the format here, you gotta change to FLAC. Click OK. And then click Extract. I'm gonna close this so you can automatically open the folder for me. I'll click Extract. As you can see, it automatically ejects the CD and also it opens the folder for me and gave me all the information that I needed. So SoundJuicer to me is the best one. Automatically to eject the CD, automatically open the folder for you, and that's the best thing. But Rhythmbox is good too, and Bandsheet is to automatically download the album information on the internet to be the best one too. That's it. That's about this video. I'm not gonna play the music because copyright problem. Oh, not finished yet. Press F11 to go full screen. See you next video.